let's start with a broad context set on the key areas where technology can be a game changer for a manufacturing company. Archit, I'd like to bring you in and hear your thoughts on this.
Right. So thank you for having me. And Gautam, like basically from a manufacturing perspective, right, like what we have observed is four or five areas in which technology is really being adopted, as you rightly commented on, like COVID-19 has completely transformed the way in which businesses are thinking about technology. And CFOs and CIOs across the board have started to really think about like the applications and really adopt technology further especially the manufacturing sector. Like few things where we are observing massive change are one is like data insights and visualizations, which is driven by like now folks have had to go completely remote, like a visualization and visibility on inventory, demand planning, forecasting, supply planning. These have moved to now more and more digital tools. Like folks have started to use Tableau and other technologies to understand like where they are, like from an informed decision making to using analytics to like identify which decisions to do. Some of the other things we've started observing are AR and AP cycles and digitization in the accounts receivables and accounts payables, given that like now in-person visits, et cetera, may be less common. Like there may be a complete order to cash cycle, which is happening digitally. There may be a complete procure to pay cycle happening digitally for many, many, many manufacturing businesses where the interaction now has moved from like somebody visiting the distributor or visiting the supplier to the entire ordering process, the entire servicing process being digital and only the movement of goods and documentation happening at this point. The third one we have observed is like around working capital. Like one is forecasting working capital needs, identifying them. Then the second part is like due to innovations in things like invoice discounting, which is a rapidly emergent item, and especially in the manufacturing sector, where what we are observing with invoice discounting is more and more large manufacturers want to make sure that their supply chains continue to be healthy. COVID has had multiple waves and lockdowns, which has led to disruptions in both demand, supply, manufacturing, labor, multiple things. Now, in those scenarios, the access to capital, it becomes very, very critical during these windows of pressure. So what we have observed is like businesses are adopting more digital mechanisms of working capital, where bill factoring, invoice discounting, access is really creates a whole lot of difference from strengthening the supply chain and bringing certain things to the as a large anchor, bringing certain things to the entire supply chain and taking care of vendors at this point. The fourth thing we have observed is which is radical in our view is the complete shift in tax compliances, digitization of the entire compliance suite. India implemented in the midst of pandemic, which is like pretty bold as a country as we go, electronic invoicing, electronic way bill, along with GST. Obviously the reform kicked off in 2017, but 2020 is when we said as a country, hey, we need to digitize every single invoice, and we started that. And so what happened with that is like we have started to digitize every single invoice. We are seeing like QR codes on for UPI receiving, every invoice is getting B2C QR codes. More and more digital payment adoption is happening as we speak. Like businesses have completely moved to full UPI order to cash cycles and what have you been, and we are observing that in the market, right? So what this has led to is the compliance and the government-driven digitization is leading to second order and third order effects, which means businesses are saying, hey, if we are transacting with our distributors and our suppliers are sending us data digitally, why do we need teams which are entering data manually, or why are we doing GST reconciliations, et cetera, manually? Why can't it all be digitized, freeing up like much needed capacity in the finance function, in the finance teams, and costs not going up at the human capital level in these functions, right? Actually costs going down because the regulatory push to digitize everything, right? Like, and we've seen these tailwinds in terms of the NPCI, the GSTN, the Aadhaar stuff. We are seeing these tailwinds everywhere.